today. I'm headed to Vienna. I'm currently at Gdansk Airport. I don't know if I say it right. In Poland. And I'm waiting for my next leg of flight to Vienna. First travel after the pandemic. So it was smooth. I had a 30-minute delay on my first leg of flight, and I was so scared that I wouldn't make it to my connecting flight to Vienna. But right now I'm here and I'm waiting for us to start boarding. And it's quite beautiful here. I mean, I like the airport. It's very organized and it has everything that you need. It's not that small, but it's not massive either. So it was very easy to navigate, especially if you're like short of time from, you know, having a delayed first leg of flight and then you have to catch your connecting flight. So I thought that I was really gonna get lost and then miss my next flight, but I didn't. I'm a little bit jaded, and I had a quick snack, and I'm really looking forward to being in Vienna tonight at 7 p.m. I think my flight comes in at 7 p.m. Just gonna drop off my bags and then start to explore Vienna that night. I'm gonna take you along with me. You know, first travel of the year, and I'm traveling solo too. I'm just gonna let you have a quick glimpse of the airport. Landed in Vienna and I'm off to grab my luggage. I didn't have a check-in, it was supposed to be just a hand luggage, but I had excess luggage, so I had to pay by the counter when I was about to board, and they took my luggage and told me that I have to pick it up from baggage hall when I arrive instead of it being a cabin luggage. So that's where I'm off to. So I'm at the baggage hall, just waiting for my luggage, and it's not out yet. So I do have a pickup car that's gonna take me to the hotel. The hotel kindly booked that for me, so it'd be nice. I mean, I don't mind taking the Cat Express or the bus or the train, but I think much faster if I take a cab and then I drop off my luggage and then start to explore the city, because I've lost like half a day of travel, so we want to make the most of it here in Vienna. Stay tuned for more.
Hotel Flemings.
Yes, Hotel Flemings, please. Thank you.
Touched your
check-in process was very smooth. It was very fast. It took about 15 minutes. So now I have to search for my broom. It's on the third floor. And here we go. 3:35. So this is the hallway. I reckon mine would be towards the end. Almost there. I'm quite hungry already, so I'm just gonna drop off my luggage, maybe freshen up a wee bit, and then find somewhere to eat. Yep, somewhere here. Oh, it's quite dark. Okay. 3:33. And that's my room. Okay. Let's get my key. Whoops. What a mess. Okay. Here we go. Ooh la la. Check this out. Wait, let me insert the card here. Ooh. Not bad, not bad. Not bad at all. This is sexy. Ooh. First, let's see what view I have. Not much of a view, but not too bad. Not too shabby. Ooh, I love my room. Nice. Perfect. Let's get everything I need. So I've got a coffee maker, a safe. What's in here? I like a full body mirror, always. Oh, I like that it's separated. Yeah, I didn't even realize I need a loo. Okay. Hello. So, needless to say, I'm very impressed with the room. And I can't wait to get a wee bit of a rest. Since I didn't eat all day, I just had snacks. So I'm gonna freshen up, wash up a bit, have a change of clothes, and go hunt for something to eat. Maybe schnitzel, I don't know. So the first half day of my stay in Vienna is almost over. I decided to hit the sack a wee bit earlier because I want to save some energy and start early tomorrow and have, you know, I want to be able to cover as much as I can of most of those some historical places that I've been meaning to visit for a long time now. I mean, this trip in Vienna is long overdue. And of course, coffee culture. So I'm gonna try visit 5 of the oldest coffee shops, would I say, or cafe restaurants in Vienna. Hopefully I get to cover all 5. I'm gonna make a separate video, maybe, if I can, just focusing on all 5 restaurants, coffee shops and what they're about and a wee bit of its history. And like when I looked at my itinerary today, it just dawned on me that 4 days in Vienna won't be enough to do all the things that I want to do. And I will be going to Bratislava after, because I've never been to Slovakia before and I've always wanted to visit Slovakia too. And now I'm thinking, after Slovakia, should I go to Lithuania or Prague? So decisions. But for now, I guess I'm just gonna get some rest, have my beauty sleep, and start early tomorrow. Tomorrow's another day of adventure. So, good night, everyone.